knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Phylum Loricifera, the microscopic armor bearers, are often placed within the higher clade of Scelidophora, along with Cynorhynchia and Priapulida. Their discoverer referred to them as jewel animals, but their name comes from the Latin lorica, meaning corselet, which is a type of armor that covers one's torso, and ferre, meaning to bear. They are an exclusively marine, free-living, myofaunal group of microscopic animals that were described in 1983 by the Danish zoologist Reinhard Mobjerg Christensen. If that name sounds familiar, it's because he discovered three separate animal phyla. In addition to Loricifera, he also discovered Cycliophora in 1995 and Micronathozoa in 2000, both of which were discussed earlier in this series. In discussing Loricifera, we will go over their history of discovery, biodiversity, form and function, life cycle, and finally their ability to survive in anoxic environments. The first loriciferans were collected from marine sediments in 1974 in North Carolina, USA, and Helsingør, Denmark. Since these specimens were actually juveniles, they were determined to be some kind of larvae of an unknown animal. The first adults were later discovered in France, and the phylum was described shortly thereafter. The exact number of loriciferan species is unknown at present. In 2021, there were officially 43 described species, but at the same time, there were also at least 100 additional unique specimens that had been collected and were being studied. In addition, there are still ongoing investigations pulling up new samples of potentially unknown species. Depending on when you're watching this tutorial, their official species count may have doubled or even quadrupled. Though most specimens live within coarse sediment at depths between 20 and 450 meters, there are others that live in extreme saline environments in the deep sea, and at least one species was discovered surviving at a depth of over 8,000 meters, or about 5 miles. At present, we do not have a good grasp on their total biodiversity. Loriciferans have a unique anatomy. Their bodies are split into 5 regions: the mouth cone, the head or introvert, neck, thorax, and abdomen. They possess scalids, which are curved spines used to sense their environments and move. Their abdomens are covered by a lorica into which their entire bodies can contract when startled. Most of their organs are housed in their abdomen, and their relatively large brain fills most of the head region. Nerves from the brain connect to the oral spines, or scalids, which relay sensory information from their environment. Juvenile forms somewhat resemble adults and include a distinct larval stage known as the Higgins larva. Loriciferans show a wide range of life cycles that may or may not include dioecious adults or hermaphroditism in the adult phase, and a series of larval and post-larval stages. Though the Higgins larva is common, there are unique larval forms like the ghost larva, mega larva, and Shira larva. However, the most well-known life cycle comes from Nanoloricus mysticus. In this cycle, sperm externally fertilize an egg from which the Higgins larva develops and grows in size as it feeds. It then molts through ecdysis multiple times and metamorphizes into a post-larva, which matures into the adult female or male, which produce eggs or sperm. However, this is just one loriciferan life cycle, and there are many others. Loriciferans were the first known animals to survive without mitochondria, meaning they do not need oxygen to survive, a characteristic they share with the cnidarian Myxozoans. At least some species are able to complete their entire life cycle in completely anoxic environments in the deep hypersaline basins of the Mediterranean Sea, more than 3,000 meters underwater. Hypersaline basins are lakes of ultra-salty, oxygen-free water more than a mile below the surface of the ocean. They do not mix with the waters above them and are dangerous or often deadly to marine animals. They are considered to be some of the most hostile and extreme environments on our planet, and yet they teem with microbial life, such as chemosynthetic prokaryotes and eukaryotic heterotrophs. While at least three species of loriciferans have been discovered in these waters so far, it's possible that there are many more. Only additional studies will allow us to unravel their mysteries. And that wraps up our investigation of these fascinating animals, the loriciferans.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.